yours now, sweetie. I run out of my repertoire.
Amen. I'd like to just say yes, yes, yes to that song. Are you washed in the blood? I sure am. I'm glad I am. If I wouldn't, I'd get am. Amen. Praise the Lord. It's good to see you tonight. Good to have you in the Lord's house. We've had a great day today. Wonderful blessing this morning on our anniversary celebration, our homecoming. Had a good service this morning. I thank the Lord for that. And also we had some good singing. Brother Ed sang for us this morning. And just had some good fellowship. We had a tremendous meal this evening. I know some of you are probably still sleet and full from that. But we had a good meal and appreciate so much. Got a good crowd come back tonight. You always have those that won't make it back on Sunday night. But I'm sure I'm glad you put forth the effort to get here. And appreciate having our visitors with us tonight. Thank you for coming. And we have a missionary family with us tonight that just came by. The Manley family, we're glad to have them with us. I'm going to have him to introduce himself and family in just a moment, in just a few moments. But we're glad to have them to stop by and visit with us. I'm glad to have one of our missionaries that we support with us tonight, Brother Raleigh Lindsay, and his family's with us. And we appreciate them being here. And Dr. Ray Robinson, of course, and his wife, Donna, we're so glad to have them tonight. And as I said this morning, Dr. Ray, it's been a tremendous blessing to this church and his people. And I appreciate Dr. Ray and all that he's done for us and what he's done for the Lord, and what a blessing that was. I'm glad we caught him at the end of his ministry with ABC Ministries. ABC Ministries was assisting Baptist churches, and we are one, and we needed his assistant, and he helped us. Amen. And I appreciate him doing that. We wasn't the very last one, but we were pretty close what we got. So next to the last. The other one was up in Virginia, wasn't it? Yeah. Yeah, that's right.
We're in West Virginia.
Where? What was that? Where was that in West Virginia?
Berkeley Springs.
Berkeley Springs.
Got you covered.
He's from West Virginia.
Oh my goodness.
Bill and Henrietta back there, they're from West Virginia, but they don't tell anybody. Brother Bill worked in the coal mines.
Amen.
Up in West Virginia. He worked up there for a total of eight.
What, 8 hours?
8 hours. He said if he could got out in 8 minutes, he'd have been 8 minutes. But once he got in, he couldn't come out. And as far as I'm concerned, that's a pretty smart man, amen. They wouldn't have got me in there. I don't believe I could lay down on one of them carts and rolled off when I got in there. And I could have definitely rolled off when I got out. But I don't know about this other deal. But I appreciate being here. And I enjoy coming to church, and I enjoy having a good time and smiling a little bit and having a little laugh and just enjoy the goodness of God. You know, the world's not the only people that can have a good time. In fact, I think we're having the best time we could ever have with the Lord Jesus Christ as we serve him and honor him and work for him. And what a blessing that is. Sister, your husband's sitting over here. If you go out that door and come in that other, you'll be almost right where he's at. Amen. Brother, she wasn't looking too hard. I thought I'd help you out. Amen. Well, good. Well, praise the Lord. We're going to have a good time tonight. Brother Ed's going to sing for us again. Dr. Ray's going to preach for us. And we're going to just enjoy the goodness of the Lord. We're going to pray and ask God's blessing to be upon us tonight. And pray for our folks, some of our folks that are sick. Brother Clarence Epley's in the hospital. We want you to pray for him. We have some of our folks that's going to be looking, facing surgery in a few weeks. And then we have some that are recovering from surgery. Diane, she's hobbling around from her knee surgery. Glad she got to come back today. And continue to pray for Patsy Brewington that's recovering from back surgery. And pray for our shut-ins. Let's don't forget to pray for them. I miss them. I wish they could be here, but because of health reasons, they can't. But let's lift them up to the Lord in prayer. Let's stand, if you would, please, and we'll go to the Lord in word of prayer, and we'll ask the Lord's blessing to be upon us. And Dustin, where you at, Dustin? Dustin, how about getting Brother Ed a cup of water, please? And we'll ask Brother Raleigh Lindsay, if you would. Would you lead us in prayer, Brother Raleigh? Yes. Yes. Granted our Father. Yes. Granted Jesus. Yes. Amen. Thank you.
Amen. Remain standing, please. Turn your hymn books, page 365. Page 365. Over the last 11 years, Pastor mentioned this morning, we've seen many things that a man would tell you couldn't happen. I'm glad that God said it could.
Amen.
One thing that's remained all through these 11 years is we've trusted in Jesus, and it's been sweet every day. We'll sing the first, second, and last verse, "'Tis so sweet to trust in Jesus."
Trust in Jesus just to
Thank you so much. You may be seated.
Well, as I said already, it's been a great day today, and I think it'll only get better. And I'm looking forward to the remainder of the service. But tonight, this being our homecoming, we started having our evening service back. We used to have a service after we had lunch, but it's so hard to keep the folk here. They get full. They want to get home, get a little rest, and they don't stay a lot of folk don't stay after they have lunch. So we started eating lunch, going home, and then coming back. It seemed like it's worked better the last couple of years, so I appreciate you being here. And it's all about being in the Lord's house. I don't think we could ever come too much. And it's certainly good to see some tonight. We haven't seen in a while. It sure is good to have you in the church. And this being our anniversary, I told Brother Ed and Jamie, I said, I'm going to just see if anybody has anything they want to share with us. Since it's our 11th anniversary, and from the congregation, if there's something that, a special blessing, I don't want it to, get lengthy or long, but if you just got a praise or something, I want to let you do that this evening for just a few moments, give an opportunity to just share with you maybe what the Lord's meant to you down through the years through the work here at Emmanuel Baptist Church. So anybody, might not be anybody, but if anybody does, would you stand up? Don't make me have to kick, pump, and prime. Don't make me have to do like I did the choir this morning. Amen. I had to fill the choir up, calling them up from the congregation, but it worked. Amen. Anybody got anything you'd like to stand up and say about the Lord and the work? Or you don't have to be necessarily about this church, but about the Lord. Amen. It's all about Him anyway. Anybody? I figured you would. I like that song. It is no secret what God can do, what He's done for others, He'll do for you. Amen. And let me just say this while I'm thinking about our mission endeavors and our mission program. We're 11 years old, and we have 55 missionaries that we support at our church, and I thank the Lord for that. All 55 of them, I thank God for that. Took a young man on just about 3 weeks ago, and what a blessing it was. So I thank God for our mission program. And let me just say this. I believe with all my heart, we're where we're at today because of our mission endeavors. Amen. I'm a mission-minded pastor, and we are a mission-minded church, and I want our people to be mission-minded. This is a very, very important ministry, and I appreciate every one of you that support the mission budget monthly here at the church through Faith Promise. What a blessing it is. Brother Danny. Charter. Amen. Amen. Yes, sir. Amen. Thank you, Brother Danny. We still got a little bit for you to do around here, too, buddy. He ain't run out yet. Sister Vesta. Amen. Yes. Amen. Dot. Amen. What now? Where we started church? Yes, ma'am. No. It was Bubba's Barbecue. It was a restaurant. They wanted to name it Bubba Baptist, but that didn't happen. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yes, ma'am. Amen. We sure will. Amen. You probably thought my name was Bubba, didn't you? We got a Bubba, but he's not. He was here this morning. He has to work at night. Brother Robert? Amen. Amen. God bless you, Brother Robert. Appreciate you, buddy. Karen? Amen. Amen. Thank God for that. Amen. Bless your heart. Boy, we can't get enough prayer, brother, buddy. Amen. Praise the Lord. Brother Buddy got saved out of Mormonism. That's a blessing within itself. I'm going to share this for Brother Buddy. Help me if you don't mind me saying this. But you don't mind, do you? Of course, you don't know what I'm going to say, do you? But anyway, when Buddy first started coming to church here, got saved, he first started coming to church here, he saved out of Mormonism. I didn't know anything about Mormonism other than I know they wasn't right with God. I knew they didn't believe in the blood of Jesus, and I knew that it was a cult. But we were sitting back there talking one day, and he told me this. He said, Pastor, he said, I bought underwear for the first time this week. I said, what? What does that got to be doing? What's that got to be doing? Anything doing being saved? Telling me he bought underwear for the first time. But the more, you should have said, hey, I see look on your face. You should have seen look on mine. But they wear something other than that. Right, buddy? And they don't. I don't want to know what they wear. I'm all right with that, amen. But he sort of, that was a shocker when he told me that. I said, what? I said, where's this counseling going? But anyway, boy, I'm glad God saves people out of religion, amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. We'll take a couple more if anybody's got anything they'd like to say. Hey, we'll let you come back too, amen. Praise the Lord. We'll take one more. Anybody? Cindy? Hallelujah. Amen. You'll never go wrong with bringing your children up in a good fundamental church that believes the Bible and preaches the book and teaches the book. You'll never go wrong with that. Sister Donna? Yeah. Amen. 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 It's good to know that our ways are not God's ways. And God has a plan and a purpose for every person. I believe that with all my heart. Now, whether we follow through that plan or not, that's between us. A lot of times we don't stay in His will so we can work in our life. But Brother Jamie can correct me if I'm wrong. But from what I understand, when Jamie and Cindy came to our first service on May the 1st, 2005, in that little building, the very first service we had on a Sunday morning. Now, we did have a Wednesday night service before that, but our first Sunday morning, if I'm not mistaken, they only came that Sunday morning because it was our first service, and they were not planning on staying. See where they're at, don't you? So I'm thankful the Lord can work in our lives. And I appreciate Him leading them this way and seeing them grow up in the church and their kids grow up in this church and get saved. That is a blessing. That is really a blessing. That's what it's all about in the Lord's work. Well, I appreciate those good testimonies. I know we could have many, many more. But we're going to let Brother Ed sing now. And if he'll come and render some specials. And then after he sings, Dr. Ray's going to be preaching for us. And looking forward to that. Amen. I don't forget. I'm like a big old pink-eared elephant. I don't forget nothing. Amen. All right, Brother Ed Crawford. Amen. Good to have you with us, brother.
Amen.
Bless your heart. I would say.
I would say we need to turn the mic on. I would say without reservation, this is one of the favorite churches that I have all over the country. Amen. I traveled all kinds of them. Big ones, fat ones, tall ones, and small ones. But I can tell you when I know I'm coming here, it's always a blessing, and I mean that. He's worthy, God's worthy, Almighty Creator, Alpha, Omega, beginning and the end. Holy, holy, Lord God Almighty, which was and is to come. Blessings and glory, wisdom and power, God my rock, in Him will I trust. My strong tower and my refuge, Savior, deliver, and soon coming King. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. He's worthy, God's worthy, Almighty Creator, Alpha, Omega, beginning and the end. Holy, holy, Lord God Almighty, which was and is to come. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. The King will come in the clouds with great power and glory with Him. But no man knows the day nor the hour, but we'll wait His soon return. Hallelujah,
hallelujah.
Glory, glory,
glory,
hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise His name. Hallelujah,
hallelujah.
Glory, glory,
glory,
hallelujah,
hallelujah.
Praise His name. He's the Alpha and Omega, the beginning, thank God He's the end. Hallelujah, glory, glory, hallelujah, praise His name. Hallelujah, glory, glory, praise His name. Hallelujah, glory, glory, hallelujah. He's worthy, God's worthy, Almighty Creator, hallelujah, praise His name, praise the name of the Lord. Amen. Just want to do a couple of this evening, and brother, again, it's an honor. I want to leave you with some meat. I want you to listen to this and see if maybe this will fit you tonight. Listen here. Are the burdens you carry seem more than your shoulders can bear? Been there, haven't we? And you can't seem to find those fair-weathered friends that promised they'd always be there. You don't have to crumble beneath all the weight. The whole world is at God's command. The stars and the planets, He just hung out in space. Now you're in the palm of His hand. You're in the palm of His hand. He fit you into His great master plan. He's got you right where you want Him. If everything's grand,
everything's grand.
Don't you know where you are? If He's in your heart, you're in the palm of His hand.
Anybody here in the palm of His hand?
Remember those days you lived under sin's rule of thumb. Listen. Sin had you wrapped round its finger so tight. The whole world was coming undone. God heard you crying. For years He kept trying. And God never gives up on a man. You just asked for one touch, but God loved you so much. Now you're in the palm of His hand. You're in the palm of His hand. He fit you into His great master plan. He's got you right where you want Him. Everything's grand.
Everything's grand.
Don't you know where you are? If He's in your heart, you're in the palm of His hand. Don't you know where you are? He's in your heart. You're in the palm of His hand.
Palm of His hand.
Oh, the palm of His hand. Oh, I'm so glad of that. There's a group been traveling around the country for a lot of years, and they've been struggling. And I thought I'd try to help them out just a little bit. They did a song several years ago that I think is one of the greatest songs ever written. And like I said, I thought I'd try to help them out, so I recorded the song. The group's called the Oak Ridge Boys. You reckon they've been struggling for a while? I want you to listen very carefully to this. You've heard this song 100 times, but let it go in and listen to this time. I was talking and I forgot my spot. There's a button here called Rewind. Watch that. That's how it works. Amen. Don't mean somebody never made a mistake. I'll show you somebody never done nothing. From now on, that's not it either. I keep going to that verse because I want it to get there, and I don't want it to get there before I'm supposed to get there. Amen. Among the local women, there'll be a slack in business. Jesse's drinking came before the groceries and the rent. Among the local women, there'll be a slack in sheep. 'Cause Jesse won't be stepping out again. Because they baptized Jesse Taylor in Cedar Creek last Sunday. Jesus gained a soul and Satan lost a good right arm. They all cried hallelujah when Jesse's head went under. 'Cause this time he went under for the Lord. Maybe this fits somebody here. The scars on Jesse's knuckles, why they're more than just respect. County courthouse records tell all there is to tell. The pockets of the gamblers will soon miss Jesse's money, and the black eye of the law will soon be well, because they baptized Jesse Taylor in Cedar Creek last Sunday. Jesus gained a soul and Satan lost a good right arm. They all cried hallelujah when Jesse's head went under, 'cause this time he went under for the Lord.
Now listen, can I borrow a phrase from Paul Harvey? Here's the rest of the story. Amen. Goes like this. From now on, Nancy Taylor can proudly speak to neighbors. Tell them how much Jesse took up with little Jim. Now Jimmy's got a daddy. Jesse's got himself a family. And Franklin County's
got a lot more man.
Because they baptized Jesse Taylor in Cedar Creek last Sunday.
Jesus gained a soul and Satan lost a good right arm. They all cried hallelujah when Jesse's head went under. But this time he went under for the Lord.
I know they baptized Jesse Taylor in Cedar Creek last Sunday. But this time he went under for the Lord.
Amen. There you go. We get through it. I don't know how I'd have made it through this life if it wasn't for Christ. I give him all the credit. I don't deserve anything. He's blessed me to have sung now full time for almost 40 years. As I told him this morning, I know I don't look near old enough to be doing it 40 years, but I am. And I love what I have done. And I love what he's allowed me to do, but it's all him. It's none of it me. I sung with the Kingsmen for 10 years. When I was there, we used to be called a ton of fun. When I left, they said half a ton went with me. But it's a joy to spend 10 of the happiest years of my life with what I consider to be one of the great organizations of gospel music. And God put me there and allowed me to learn more in 10 years than I could have learned in a lifetime. That's what God does. That's who he is. Somebody asked me to sing the chicken song. How many were here are here tonight that were not here this morning? We got a few. You got a few. All right, I'll try to. Can I do two more songs? If I get two, I'll get this in, folks. No, I won't have to. It's just that song. Wait till you get my age, you'll forget too. This, for those of you who are not familiar. Which probably isn't very many of you now. Most everybody knows what I do. I travel all over and I sing this song everywhere that I go. Nearly every service, I sing this song. Nearly every service, somebody comes up to me and tells me I ought not sing this song. And nearly every service, I tell them, you don't have to listen. I'm sick to death of political correctness. I've had it up to here. I don't care what some nincompoop on television wants to tell me. I want to go by what the Word of God has to say. As long as I do that, I don't believe that I'll have a problem. This song is what the Word of God has to say. I didn't make it up. I wished I'd have wrote it. I do. I wished I'd have wrote it because I'd have nailed it, boy, if I'd have wrote it. I'd have sent it all over the world. I can't do that because it's this other guy's song. But I wished I'd have wrote it. This is me. I need your prayers. Our ministry needs your prayers. We'll travel all over the country this year again and go and sing this song every night. Sung it every night, I guess, that we sung since about 2006. So y'all can take that for what it's worth. Here it is, most controversial song in gospel music history. It goes like this. Will you settle down? Don't get ahead of me. I turned on the television just to watch the evening news. What I saw made me want to crawl right through the tube. They were talking about a wedding, but they only showed two men. So I fired off an email with an invite just to them. Here's what I told them. Come on down to the farm. Come on out to the barn. You won't find two roosters walking arm in arm. They couldn't make a chicken. They don't have an egg to hatch. When God said love your brother, I don't think he meant like that. Oh, I see some of you haven't heard this yet, right? Now in that little email, I began to tell them how. Two mares can't make a stallion, and two bulls can't make a cow. It takes a male and female for the species to go on, and there'll be no reproduction if the plumbing is all wrong. So come on down to the farm. Come on out to the barn. You won't find two roosters walking arm in arm. They couldn't make a chicken. They don't have an egg to hatch. When God said love your brother, I don't think he meant like that. I don't believe he meant it that way either, but here's the truth that we stand on. It goes like this. Now we used to teach our children all about the birds and bees. Now the world keeps telling them just do anything you please. We need to get back to the Bible, back to the gospel truth. 'Cause a million happy ganders ain't gonna make a single goose. So come on down to the farm. Come on out to the barn. You won't find two roosters walking arm in arm. They couldn't make a chicken. They don't have an egg to hatch. When God said love your brother, I don't think he meant like that.
I don't think so, Bill.
When God said love your brother, I don't think he meant like that.
Amen. Well, we need to, you know, I've sung for 40 years. I've sung some great songs. When Mama Prayed, Heaven Paid Attention, The Captain with the Kingsman, I'll be forever remembered for Come On Down to the Farm. So thank you, music lovers. Once again, it's been a joy to be here. It's been too many years this past time since we got back, so I hope you'll all talk to Brother Frankie and have him make me come back sooner than 4 years. But it's been a joy to be here. We've met so many of our friends. And Bill, next time we'll go play golf if we have to crawl out there. And I love you. You were talking about the church. I remember that little shack, Bubba's Barbecue down there. We took a group down there and sung. And I remember it well. I came down there and sung. And some of you were there. And to see you move into this wonderful, wonderful facility, and to hear all the things that God has done, you're a blessed people. And you know what? All of us in here are blessed. Most of us have all that we need, and most of us have most of what we want. Amen? But it's not because of what we've done. It's because of what He's done through us. This church is here because of what God has done through you. You, the people that come here. You're supposed to end a song, and when you quit singing, with a high, loud song and all that kind of stuff, so you all get excited and you'll come out there and buy CDs. That's what they tell you you're supposed to do. Well, I'm not going to do that. I want you to listen. This is my testimony to you. Perhaps it'll be your testimony to someone else. Listen. Probably one of my favorite songs. Then you go like this. Looking back over the years that I've known, if I had made this journey alone, I'd be searching for meaning so empty inside, if not for the love of Christ. Now listen, I could pretend that I'm satisfied. I could make you believe I'm enjoying the ride. But the smile on my face would be a disguise if not for the love of Christ. The love of Christ, oh, the love of Christ.
treasure, no greater prize. I can't imagine living my life if not for the love of Christ.
I can't imagine, folks. He's all that we need. He's all that we have. No mercy to cover all my mistakes. There'd be no peace through my darkest days. And no hope that I'd ever see paradise if not for the love of Christ. The love of Christ, oh, the love of Christ. No finer treasure, no greater prize.
I can't imagine living my life if not for the love of Christ. If not for the love of Christ.
Appreciate that. Appreciate the love of Christ, amen. I'm glad for the love he has for each and every one of us. The Bible said he loved the whole world.
Amen.
But you know, if it had only been one, he'd went for you. He'd have loved you that way. It's good to have Brother Manley. Brother Manley, would you stand and just introduce your family and tell us where the Lord's called you and how the work's going that you're been called into? Amen.
He gave me a verse. He gave me Romans 10, 13, and 14. The Bible says, for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. And how then shall they call on him in whom they have not believed? And how shall they believe in him in whom they have not heard? And how shall they hear without a preacher? And he told me he wanted to send me. And he encouraged our hearts to go on full-time education about last June, or 5 to 6 4. And he gave me a promise in Hebrews 11, 6. The Bible says, but without faith, it is impossible to please him.
That's right. Amen. 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 Thank you, Brother Manley. We pray for you and appreciate you dropping by this evening to see us. We have a missionary that we support going to Albania. I don't know if you know Daxwell Wells. Brother Daxwell Wells, he's part of our mission budget here and been supporting him for probably a couple of years now. And appreciate Brother Daxwell. He's a blessing. And so pray for Brother Manley and his family as they continue to travel on debitation. Lord, just bless him and help him. Well, I prayed this morning, Lord, give us 160 in church. He answered that prayer, give us 167. I prayed for $11,000 offering. We didn't get it yet. It's going to come. I believe that with all my heart. I remember... when we were still in the little building, we was asking for a certain offering. Dr. Ray, you was with us. We was down there working in that hole, down there somewhere on the field. And we'd prayed for an offering, and we didn't get it. And got real close that night, and I told Dr. Ray, I said, well, I guess we just didn't get it. That next morning, a guy come by and said, preacher, how much do we like making that offering? And I told him, he said, here's a check right here to cover it. It may not come today. It might come tomorrow. It might come next week. It might come next month. But let me tell you one thing. He's going to send what the Bible says he'll give our heart's desire. But you got a chance to help tonight to give that, to reach that goal. Maybe some of you wasn't here this morning, and maybe somebody brought a check just to write out the whole thing. We need $2,300 to reach that goal of $11,000. I've seen God do it before.
Amen.
We prayed for $10,000 before, we've got it. We prayed, well, I ain't going to get on that. We'll be here all night. God's just met the need, I can tell you that. And I praise the Lord for it. And it's by his good graces that where we are today. And as Brother Ed said, it's only by the grace of God. Amen. And I do appreciate Brother Ed being with us today. You pray for him. He'll be leaving in the morning early and heading back home and taking care of his mom and dad up there. And so you pray for him. Let's have the ushers to come forward. We're going to give you an opportunity to help us reach that goal tonight. And if you want to just go ahead and make that check out, that's fine. If you want to drop in more than that, hey, if we go over it, it's not going to make me mad. If it goes over, I'll sing that song, "He Gave Me More Than I Asked For." Well, that just killed it right there, didn't it? No, I promise I won't sing, no matter. But anyway, you give tonight. And let me just say, this preacher's not begging. We've never begged for one nickel. We've never begged for one dime. We've never begged for nothing. You know what we've done? We asked for it. And God's always sent it in, and I thank him for it. So you give tonight, and I know the Lord will bless you for it. Of course, our jug offering we take up, that is for our mission endeavors. We put that in our mission work. And the little kids come down, drop these dollar bills, and whatever you give them in this jug, that goes straight to the mission field. And it's a blessing to see them little youngins come by and drop that money in. It's your money, but they're dropping it in. Brother Marvin Petit, would you pray for us and ask the Lord's blessing to be upon the offering tonight as we pray? Yes, we do, Father. Thank you for being so good to us. Yes. 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 Use it, Lord, I pray. Yes.
And the offering, Father, and we just give you all the honor and glory and praise for that which you're going to do here in this place here tonight. For it's in Jesus' holy and precious name that you pray. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Brother Marvin.
Another day is through. Someone slipped and fell. Was that someone you? You may have longed for added strength, your courage to renew. For I have news for you. It is no secret what God can do. What he's done for others, he'll do for you. Wide open. It is no secret what God can do.
Amen. Well, it's just wonderful to look around and see what the Lord has done. And what encourages my heart is to know that He's not finished yet, that He's still doing and going to continue to do. Before Dr. Ray comes and brings us the message this evening, let me make a couple of announcements. Don't forget, of course, our revival services will continue through Friday night. Tomorrow night, Brother Scott Dean will be with us. He pastors White Horse Heights Baptist Church over in Greenville. He just recently transplanted from West Virginia.
Amen.
He came down, got down to the South. Amen. So, well, I don't know about that. But anyway, we're looking forward to Brother Scott coming. He's a tremendous blessing to us. And I know you'll enjoy Brother Scott if you can come. We'll start at 7 o'clock each evening, go through Friday night. We'll have special music each night. The Sellers family will be with us tomorrow night, singing for us. And then on Tuesday night, Brother Mike Boone's going to be with us. Brother Mike Boone back there's dad's going to be singing for us, along with the Morning Star Baptist Church, the choir. They'll be here tomorrow night. Then Wednesday night, it'll be the local yokels, amen. And then Thursday night, Jessica's going to be here, and she's going to sing for us, along with Beth Wilson's going to sing. And then on Friday night, Brother John Lancaster and his family will be with us, and look forward to Brother John and his family coming. They're always a blessing. So we encourage you, if you would, please, to come every night that you can. And we certainly hope and pray. And our choir's going to be singing also each night. So all the choir members, you please try to be here and be in your place. If you don't, we'll sing with what we got. Amen. I'll fill it up again from the congregation. We'll might have to sing to the seats out there. But anyway, you come and help us this week. And if you'll come and help us, I'll guarantee you, you'll get some help. And we all need revival. And I want us to have more than just a series of meetings. I want us to experience revival. And I'd like to see us have a church revival. We may not have a church revival, but I know this. We can have individual revival. I know I need it as your pastor. And I believe every person that's in this building needs revival. We need a closer walk with the Lord. None of us is close to the Lord as we should be and ought to be. But I'm glad we have the opportunity to get that way, Brother Raleigh. We can get close to Him as we want to. The Bible says, draw nigh to Him, and He'll draw nigh to us. And we need to get close to Him, amen. And I want you to do that. If you would come and be with us each night, you can. That would be a real blessing. Then on Friday night, May the 27th, that's just a few weeks away, we have some of these out there on the tables. You come into the lobby out there. The Kingsman Quartet will be with us on May the 27th. That's on a Friday night at 7 o'clock. You're welcome to get these and take these with you and put them somewhere. If somebody lets you put them up, Brother Ed sang with the Kingsman, as you told you a moment ago, for about 10 years, some years back. And we're looking forward to them coming and being with us. And then also I'd like to mention also the sign-up sheet back there for the ladies that wants to attend the Lady Day, the Mother's Day luncheon on next Saturday, which will be the 7th, May the 7th. Just put your name down. If anybody's coming with you, just put the number of people you're bringing so they'll know how much food to prepare for and get ready for that. And that starts at 11 o'clock this coming Saturday from 11 to 2. And the men that can come out, they want us to serve them. Imagine that. Now, basically what they want us to do is clean up after they get through. I know what the deal is. But if you men can come out and help us, we'll try to take care of them, amen? And we'll pay them back when it comes fish fry time. We'll let them clean up all that mess. Lord have mercy, that's a mess. But anyway, come and help us if you can, men. That'd be a real blessing. And for one that brings the most visitors on the week of revival combined, the week, you can't count, you only count if you come, the visitor comes five times, you can only count them once. But anyway, bring your visitors with you. You'll win a Bible. And this is a King James NIV Bible. Some of you didn't get that. Now, this is a King James Scofield Study Reference Bible. You have your choice of this type, or you can have a large print, same type Bible, King James, of course, Scofield Reference Bible. You can have your choice. We have this in colors. You can have it in blue, burgundy, or black. And the large print is black only. So I want you to try to bring us. Let's fill the house up. Fill the house up for the Lord's glory. Amen. And you'll get a Bible if you bring the most visitors. Okay?
Brother Frankie?
Yes.
Let me tell you, folks, I sung with the Kingsmen for 10 years, but I also sung with them about 3 weeks ago. And I can tell you they're just as good as we ever were. And if you really want to enjoy quartet singing, you need to find your way back here on the 27th. And I promise you that you will have a good time listening to great gospel music.
Amen. Thank you, Brother. And looking forward to that so much. Well, Dr. Ray's going to come and preach for us now. But Dr. Ray, you come on. It's always a joy to have Dr. Ray with us. He's, as I said this morning, I bragged on him when he wasn't here this morning, so I'll brag on him in his absence. I'll brag on him in his presence. He's been a real blessing to this preacher. He's been a real blessing to this church, and he's been a real blessing to these people. We're still mad at Donna for taking him away from us, because I believe had he not met that young lady right over there, fell in love with her, look at him smile.
Still been. And by the way, I don't really understand yet why God didn't plant me right here. Now, I don't know. He has his way, and I'm not upset with him about it.
Right.
But every time I come over here, I talk to him a little bit about it. I say, why? Why didn't you let me stay over here? Because this is, by the way, this is one of my second most favorite, one of my two most favorite churches on the planet. Now, I got to defer to the Emmanuel Baptist Church East a little bit, amen? Got to, because that's where God put me, but I don't know why he didn't put me over here, but he didn't.
Hey.
But I'm still a little upset with him about it.
Yeah.
But we get an understanding there, amen.
Well, sure it's good to have you, Dr.
Always
Ray.
Good to be here.
Now, listen, brother.
Yeah.
Most of the time, people, you get your love offering after you get through.
Uh-oh.
But tonight, I want to give you your love offering tonight before you start. And maybe you'll put a little shortening in it, where Dennis, a little shortening in it, Brother Dennis. And so I want to go ahead and give you your love offering tonight, okay? So.
All right. Amen. I appreciate that, brother.
Yeah.
Hey.
Hey, wait a minute. You better not laugh, because you don't know what you're going to get yet.
I'm used to it by now.
What about a ham biscuit?
Yeah, all right, yes, sir.
Okay, yeah. Somebody run over at the Hardee's.
Yeah, I'll give that to Donna.
Get us a ham biscuit. Mother's Day lunch, sign up. Okay, all right. And by the way, all joking aside, I really don't know why God didn't plant me here. I spent all my about 18 months here with this pastor, and I'm going to say tonight he is the best pastor. He is the best pastor I've ever met, ever known. He's absolutely. Now, we were together, I mean, every day, almost every day for a year and a half. Now, I'd be gone some a few times this here and there, a few days. But we were together almost every day for nearly 18 months. You get to know a fella when you do that. In fact, I guess I've been with him more than I have any other man, I guess. I've been every day. Hey, every day. But now I love him. Because he, by the way, he's my pastor. And I got a chance to choose my pastor because I was traveling around in different places here and there. And when I landed with him over, see, God, I was over there at the Spanish church, called over here, and I came by here with my camper, parked it up at the food line. We came down here, Brother Danny, you and myself, and looked around, and oh, my goodness, and I knew then I was home. Walked out to those three crosses. You remember those three crosses? I don't know. They may still be there. They are still there. Walked out there around those three crosses. Oh, it was, I mean, listen, this place was bare. And oh, I'm going to get into it. But hey, love this man. He is indeed, without question, the best pastor. And I know you love him, but just don't ever, please don't ever take him for granted. Because if you do, somebody, I'm going to tell you what's the truth. Baptists are still preachers. Amen? They'll do it. But I know you won't. Sister Stevens back here, good to see you tonight. She came because she had heard that I was here. Her two daughters graduated from the East Georgia Road Christian School in Simpsonville. Back in the early 90s, along in there. One of her daughters her husband's a pastor in Lincolnton, North Carolina. And Kim, I don't know where you said she was, but Amy's in Lincolnton, right? Kim's in Lincolnton. Okay, all right. But her daughters, and she said she heard that I was here. And when she walked up out there, you remember me? And I said, yes. Then she called my hand at it. She said, well, who am I? I said, hey, I said, if it's been over 24 hours anymore, I'm not sure about anything. Amen? In fact, I had to keep my flyer on my desk there to remind me about. No, I didn't either. I've been thinking about this for a while, and it's so good to be here. Such a delight to be here with you. I love you. I love this place. My goodness. And talking about that offering, if I don't know what came in tonight, but if it didn't come in tonight, he'll go to the mailbox in the morning, and it'll probably be there. Never, never, ever seen such. Of course, I've traveled for, about 5 years from West Virginia all the way to, by the way, Brother Kurt's from West Virginia, all the way to Louisiana, working on churches and church buildings during the 05 to 09, and landed over here in 08. Spent 08, part of 07 and 08 over here. But the truth is, that was such a delight. But what a great time. And I've never had such a good time. Well, that ham biscuit, every morning he'd bring me a ham biscuit. And this pastor is the only pastor that I worked with anywhere. He was on the job every day. In fact, some of those churches and buildings I worked on, I wouldn't see the pastor for just every once in a while, but every day. And I tell you, I can't say enough about, words can't express what a blessing this man's been to me tonight. And I thank you, Pastor. You've been a blessing to this. I'm going to tell you that. Before I get started, I love you. All right, have you turned tonight with me, if you will, to Romans chapter 5 and verse 8. Romans chapter 5 and verse 8. And there, the King James Bible says, hey, amen. Hey, I tell folks about that Bible, if you can change it a little, you can change it a lot. And that's what has happened today. Boy, my goodness, you hardly recognize the word of the Bible some people use. You hardly recognize what it's saying. But you'll recognize this tonight. Romans chapter 5 and verse 8. The Bible says, but God commendeth his love toward us, that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Amen. Let's say hallelujah. Right along there. Hey, I'm going to tell you, if I didn't say anything else or do anything else or read anything else tonight, that in itself is a gospel sermon right there. Amen. Amen. In fact, I believe I'll read it again. But God commendeth his love toward us, that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Hallelujah. Amen. And Lord, we thank you tonight. Oh my, we thank you tonight with all our heart for doing just that. And Lord, we thank you for not only that, but for all that you do and have done for us. And Lord, somehow I want to try to honor you tonight. That's my purpose in being here, to honor you and try to be a blessing to someone this evening. I pray, help me do so in Jesus' name. Amen. I want to speak from this passage and a number of others tonight I'll be reading concerning the subject, two little words that changed everything. Two little words that change everything. But God. But God. Indeed, two little words, but changes absolutely everything that there is. It changes everything. The word God appears in the King James Bible 4,447 times. And each of those 4,447 times the word God appears, it is something very significant and important. 584 times the little word but appears is found associated with the reference to God. And 43 times the exact phrase but God is found in the Bible. But now I want to qualify tonight. Hey, these words two individually. I want to look at these two individually just for a few moments. But number one, I want us to look at the word God. And I want to say, first of all, that I never thought it'd come a day in America And when you said God, you'd have to identify who you're talking about. Amen? Have to make sure that folks understand who you're talking about. I want you to understand tonight who I'm talking about when I say God. I'm talking about, hey, the very idea that crowd says their God is as good as our God, that very idea those people say that all gods are the same, I say to them tonight, I'm talking about the God that back yonder before time began, from human perspective, that God who came from nowhere because there was nowhere to come from. And he stepped out where there was nowhere to stand. And he stood on nothing when there was nothing there. And I say he reached out where there was nothing to reach, and he got something where there was nothing to get. And he took that something and he flung it into the outer expanses of eternity, and worlds and universes came into being. That's the God I'm talking about tonight. I'm talking about the God that he sang, that first song you sang tonight. He's Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. He's the omnipotent one, the omnipresent one, the omniscient one. I'm talking about the God who is Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. And hey, anybody tonight wants to say their God is good as my God? They are full of lies. The devil lied about that from the very beginning. It is a lie from the pits of hell. There's only one God tonight, the God of creation, the God that you and I know to be the God of all tonight, all this universe, who knows. Hey, heard a song on the way over here tonight. We listened to Enlighten. Then that enlightened a little bit. And the song says that when a leaf falls, he hears it. When a leaf falls on the ground, he hears the sound. Hey, and a thought occurred to me. I know he knows how many hairs that I have on my... Do you know you lose over 80 hairs a day? Yeah. I read that the other day on that... Yeah. You lose an average of 80. Hey, and everyone you lose, he takes it off the tally. Every hair on your head. But I thought about, when I heard about that leaf fall to the ground and God hearing the sound, I thought about, you know, he knows how many leaves are on the tree. Amen? He knows everything there is to know, and it's a perfect knowledge. He knows it all perfectly well. I'm talking about that God. Genesis chapter 1 and verse 1, in the beginning, God. Oh my. And 26 times in chapter 1 of Genesis alone, we see the word God. And another 133 times in the rest of the book of Genesis, which of course is the book of beginnings, we see God. That's the God I'm talking about tonight. But God, the only one and true and living God. Amen. And then there's this, that little word, but. Online dictionary, Webster's online dictionary, takes 12 pages to try to explain what the word but means. Amen. B-U-T, three letters. And it's used to introduce a statement that adds something to a previous statement and usually contrasts with it in some way. Other than. Used in speech in the beginning of a sentence to express surprise, shock, etc. And I said, that's exactly what happened to Paul. That but God. He was so surprised. He said, but God commended his love toward us. He was so surprised and shocked about that tonight, and I am as well. Now, I can be honest with you. I can understand why God loves you, but I surely can't understand why he loves me that way. Amen. I tell you, listen, but God, and Paul was shocked and surprised, and then it goes on to say, notice verse 7 as well, for scarcely for a righteous man will one die, yet peradventure for a good man some would even dare to die, but God. God died for us all, every human being on the planet. You know, that surprise. I'm shocked and surprised at that. God would save the terrorists tonight. He would save that ISIS crowd. Amen. He would. If they would turn to him, he would save them just like that. Amen. He would save the terrorists tonight. But God. But that word but And now further, Webster uses a long list of definitions, but the one that is most intended for me tonight, most clear for me tonight, is this. Webster says that that word "but" changes everything. Changes. I mean, that changes everything that has gone before. And I want to say tonight in this passage that I read in your hearing, but God, our text, but God commendeth his love toward us. While we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Now, folks, listen to me tonight. That changes everything. That changes absolutely everything. This makes the difference between eternal torment and eternal bliss. In Luke chapter 16, verses 19 through 25, describes a man who went to hell, lifted up his eyes in hell, being in torments, and seeth Abraham afar off with Lazarus in his bosom. And listen to me tonight, you and I were headed for that awful place called hell. We were on our way, you listen, we were on our way to hell one day to live in eternal torment from all eternity. I can't get my mind, and you can't either, around this matter of eternity. We accept the fact that we're going to live forever with the Lord Jesus Christ. But can you imagine tonight for a moment on our way to a devil's hell for eternity? I read that passage and it breaks my heart for all who go there. But I say to you tonight, you and I were headed that way. We were headed for hell. We deserved hell, by the way. But God. All our way to a devil's hell for all eternity. You understand what I'm saying? I'm saying we were headed for that fire and brimstone, the lake of fire which burneth with brimstone, where the worm dieth not, the fire is not quenched. We were on our way there. You and I. But God, but God, but God. And it, hey, that changed everything right there, brother. Changed everything, right? But God, but God. And let me say, Revelation chapter 20, 15. The Bible says that whosoever was not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire. Revelation 21, 8 says, but the fearful and unbelieving. Hey, that's where we were, unbelieving, and the abominable and murderers and whoremongers and sorcerers, and all idolaters shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. But God. Revelation 21. Revelation chapter 21 and verse 1. We changed that hell for this picture right here. And I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and first earth were passed away. There's no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of God is with men. He will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them and be their God. God shall wipe away all tears. And then, on and on, it tells about the wonderful, beautiful place called heaven. Preached on heaven in our church this morning. The subject, do you want to go to heaven? Do you want to go to heaven tonight? Oh, and we can. How? But God. But God. But God. But then, further in Genesis chapter 3, I'm sorry, about chapter 31. Genesis chapter 31 and verse 7. The Bible says, and your father hath deceived me and changed my wages 10 times. Now we know this is the story over there, Laban and Rachel's father, Leah's father, and all this with what happened to Jacob. But he says, your father had deceived me and changed my wages 10 times. But look here. But God suffered him not to hurt me. Hey, not to hurt me. Hey, we are under divine protection tonight. Now, if you don't think there's some people out to hurt you tonight, you just go out there and look around a little bit and somebody hurts you if they can. But they can't. Not one hair. Hey, get back to those hairs. You don't want to talk about that. Not one hair can fall from our head tonight without God knowing and allowing it to happen. But God. Jacob said, hey, boy, that fella had it in for me. And the devil's got it in for you and I, yes, too. Amen. He hates us tonight. And by the way, I hate him, too. Yes, amen. But he hates us. But God. I say nothing, absolutely nothing in all the land tonight can hurt you or me, but that God's already approved it, allowed it, and it's going to turn out just right for us. Hey, boy, every day or two, and I know you have it here as well as down our way, every day or two you hear that word cancer. Oh, my. But God. But God. And by the way, we've had more funerals in our this year than ever in my ministry. I guess I've had one at least. Just right and left and here, coming here and there. Just pile that one right after the other almost. You see, the devil is indeed a roaring lion. Walking about, Peter says, seeking whom he may devour. And he loved to have you and I for supper tonight. Not to feed us either. Amen. He loved to have us. He loved to destroy us tonight. But God suffered him not to hurt me. Oh. See, there's no safe place on earth today. Not one. I mean, even in church, my goodness, just this past weekend, y'all know you saw where people had a shootout at church. Grace, just can you imagine? Never thought it would be, but it is. It is happening everywhere you turn. There's no safe place on earth but God. Where we are, we make that he can't hurt us. I love that Psalm 121. I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills. From which cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord which made heaven and earth. Oh, nothing, absolutely nothing can happen to me tonight and you tonight but God. Then Genesis chapter 50 and verse 20. And no, I don't plan to go all the way through the Bible. There are 4,447 times, but we won't get to all those tonight, I promise. Genesis chapter 50 and verse 20. There the Bible says, but as for you, ye thought evil against me, but God meant it unto good to bring to pass as it is this day to save much people alive. But God. Our choir does a song, Till God Turns This Thing Around. And he will do. I said something about that kind of lay. Hey, you know, I'm saying tonight that God, no matter what is looking bad for you, God has already filtered it. He's already checked it out. He's already approved it. And it's nothing going to happen to us tonight that he doesn't want to happen to us. And we can rest assured tonight we're safe and sound in his arms. But God, those things that are looking mighty poor on us this evening. And I know there's some folks right here that got looking on the horizon at some questionable and some frightening things on the horizon. But let me say to you tonight, but God. But God. Oh, he can turn it around. He can turn it around. Hey, you know, no wonder the devil's mad all the time. Amen? Oh, he gets us lined up in his crosshairs, and he's got us where he wants us, and we're sitting duck, and all of a sudden God just changes everything. Amen? Hey, no wonder he's mad all the time. Amen. I'd be mad too. Because he can't get by with any. Oh, my. Some of you tonight, he got you in his crosshairs and maybe has right now. Even if you're looking down that barrel of the devil's weapon, the gun tonight, and you're staring down that gun, hey, don't you worry. But God. But God turned that thing around and make it happen for good. Don't you worry. And I know we're in frightening days. Everything is just going wrong, seems like. But God. Hey, now let me say as well, let's back up just a moment to page. Oh, he ain't going ahead. He's backing up. Let's back up to Genesis 48 tonight. And Israel, verse 21. Genesis 48. And Israel said unto Joseph, that's Jacob, said to Joseph, behold, I die, but God shall be with you and bring you again unto the land of your fathers. Oh, my goodness, but God. Say, we're not alone. John chapter 14, verse 18 says, I will never leave you nor forsake you. Hey, by the way, I'm going to hold him to that too. Amen. I hold him to that. Hey, Lord, now you made me a promise. Amen. I remind him from time to time. Now, I was just doing, I'm not upset. But I would have really liked to have been a part. Oh, my goodness. And I'm talking about earlier about the folks here to love. I miss old Wolf. Oh, my goodness. And, Larry bought a rotten cantaloupe. Come by one day, bought a rotten cantaloupe, and hung around for 10 years. Amen. I miss some fellas, but old Wolf, I tell you. He and I came along about the same time. You remember that? And he said, that first Christmas party we had over there at the building over there, and you said something about the little drummer boy. and he was there. That was one of the first things he had come to. And I said, well, I know it. I don't have any music. And I stood up and sang Little Drummer Boy a cappella at that Christmas party. He told me a number of times after that, when I saw that old white Eddie man stand up and sing that song, he said, I knew I was home. He and I, oh my, him and myself, we kind of locked up there. We'd sit back there in that one spot in that building over there, and I had just a time of our life. Oh, Matthew chapter 28, verse, y'all pardon me, I just get a little nostalgic, okay, Matthew 20:28, he says, lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world. And that simply means that God will go with us to the jumping off place and then jump off with us. Amen. Hey, I'm saying he'll go with us all the way. The songwriter put it this way, I don't have to cross Jordan alone. Now, I know, that's sort of, it's really crossing Jordan is going into the promised land of Christian service and all that dedication in life. But it's a good song anyway. And wherever I go, I won't have to go. My Lord knows the way through the wilderness. And all I have to do is follow. Strength for today is mine all the way, and all that I need for tomorrow. My Lord knows the way through the wilderness, and all I have to do is follow. Hey, we won't have to go anywhere alone. We won't. He will be with us all the way home. Exodus chapter 13 and verse 18. My, that's a splendid little oath. And it says, Exodus chapter 13, verse 18. But God led the people about through the way of the wilderness of the Red Sea, and the children of Israel went up harnessed out of the land of Egypt. I love that. I love that word, harnessed. Now, it's almost, you see anymore, and it's almost a necessity. You see parents in a store with their kids on a leash with a harness on them. Amen. And keep up with them young'uns. Well, hey, God does us the same way. He's got us on a leash and a harness. That's what that verse says right there. Harnessed. He said, I let him up harnessed. I love that, brother. Hey, I don't have to. Hey, I'm a little bit, I run, you know, I get carried away and run around a little bit sometimes. And In fact, every Monday, the grass looks greener over yonder somewhere. Amen. Amen. No, just kidding. But the truth is, I don't have to worry about that. Well, God got me on that leash.
Right.
And sometimes he has to jerk on me,
yeah.
Pull me back a little bit.
Yes, sir.
So, no, son, you right where I put you. You stay right there. If I need you, I'll come get you. Harnessed out of the land of Egypt. You know, boy, they looked like, you know, the Bible said they wandered in the wilderness for 40 years. They weren't wandering. I mean, you know, I know that's the way. God had them right there, harnessed, guiding every step of the way. And I look back on my life and look like I took a detour here and there somewhere along the way. You didn't take one, did you? I've taken some detours along the way. But you know what? All the while, God had me. God had me. Proverbs 16:9. I love that verse. I live by that verse. It says this. A man's heart deviseth his way, but the Lord directeth his steps.
Amen.
And so I just, you know, my heart's desire, just come over here and hang out with you guys. Amen. But the Lord directeth my steps. And of course, the Lord knew if I hung around over here much longer, there ain't no clothes in the world that'd fit me, would they? Because it isn't sitting right here. Amen. Good gracious, the Lord. Hey, some of you, oh, my goodness, if you missed out on that, you just missed out on something. She fed one day 33 workers. And I mean, when I say fed, I'm not talking about a pimento cheese sandwich either. We had Sunday dinner every day. Every day. And I'm glad God's leash and harness brought me over here for that good time to go. Oh, my, bless your heart. Thank you so much for taking such a... And church-wide, y'all took care of me. Good gracious aliveness, Pastor Dave. Hey, but harnessed. Then there's another thing. Judges, chapter 15. Judges, chapter 15, verse 18 and 19 says this. And he was sore athirst. And called on the Lord and said, Thou hast given this great deliverance unto the hand of thy servant. And now shall I die for thirst? Die for thirst. Boy, I've said it and you have too. Of course, now if you hadn't picked cotton, you don't know what it means. But I'm about to perish to death. Ever said that? I'm about to. But here it is. He said, I'm about to die. I'm going to die of thirst. And fall into the hand of the uncircumcised, but God, cleaved a hollow place that was in the jaw. And there came out water thereof. And when he had drunk, his spirit came again and he revived. I like that word too. Revived. Oh my goodness. Hey, God's children get thirsty. God's got a plan. Amen. Even if he has to just cleave out a hollow place in the jaw, let water come out of it. Good. Can you imagine that, brother? I mean, you're talking about provision.
Yeah.
Hey, yeah, you know, I know he gave them water out of the rock. I understand that. You know, I all that. But I mean, he just, just gave him water.
Amen.
Standing there in his tracks. Didn't have to do anything. Oh, but God. He was thirsting to death. He's going to fall into the hand of his enemies. But God. In Psalm chapter 75, we only like 4,000, 400 and about 40 or so. Amen. No, no, I'm just kidding. Judges chapter 15. Oh, I did that one. Oh, Psalm 75, verse 6. For promotion cometh neither from the east, nor from the west, nor from the south, but God is the judge. He putteth down one and setteth up another. Now, I'm not going to get too carried away in this tonight, but I know I'm probably joining everybody here and saying, I am sickened by the direction of America tonight. I am. And by the leadership of America, I am sickened by the direction our leaders are taking us tonight. And it just, oh, it grieves my heart and soul just like it does yours. But God. But God. The book of Daniel. Daniel chapter 4, verse 17. This matter is by the decree of the watchers and the demand by the word of the holy ones, and to the intent that the living may know that the Most High ruleth in the kingdom of men and giveth it to whomsoever he will and setteth up over it the basis of men. Verse 25 of this same chapter says this, that they shall drive thee from men, and thy dwelling shall be with the beasts of the field, and they shall make thee to eat grass as oxen, and they shall wet thee with the dew of heaven, and seven times shall pass over thee till thou know that the Most High ruleth in the kingdom of men, and giveth it to whomsoever he will. Verse 32. And they shall drive thee from men, and thy dwelling shall be with the beasts of the field, and they shall make thee to eat grass as oxen. Seven times shall pass over thee, until thou know that the Most High ruleth in the kingdom of men, and giveth it to whomsoever he will. Proverbs 21:1 says this. This is my sanity. My sanity lies in this, is the fact that Almighty God, the king's heart is in the hand of the Lord. And like the rivers of water, he turneth it whithersoever he will. So, now, the sad truth is, America's gotten what we deserve. That's the sad truth. But my sanity lies in the fact that God put this crowd in charge up yonder. God put them in charge for his own purpose. Of course, he did. I know why he did it. Oh, my goodness. I preached a message recently about why are we losing? And we're losing. We're losing. Oh, we're losing ground every day. We're losing our way of life. We're literally in a battle for our way of life in America, and we're losing. Why are we losing? I tell you why. Because we won't do what 2 Chronicles 7:14 says. And the fact that 1 John tells us that whosoever biddeth this crowd, God's speed is partaker of their evil deeds. Voting time's come. I don't get into it. But I'll tell you one thing. If God's people had been voting right all along, and I'm talking about all of God's, everybody that names the name Christian had been voting right, we wouldn't be in the mess that we're in today. We wouldn't be in this mess. Good gracious, we're in a mess. But God, and he's just giving us what we deserve. Now there's a few others. Let's see. but God will redeem thy soul. Oh, hey, he's going to take us all the way home. But God overthroweth the wicked for their wickedness. Hey, I'm going to, hey, you know, it's, there must undoubtedly, in fact, there got to be a new brand of Christianity that I don't know anything about. Amen. Because there's some folks today claiming to be a Christian and doing some things that I know don't line up with what I believe about this book. Christian love all things. Good gracious alive. But God. I'm going to do this and be done. To our celebration today. 12 years ago, Pastor was at the Carolina, I was at Carolina Baptist Church as associate pastor and working at the bivocational, working at the lumber yard. 12 years ago, that was where you were. But God. But God designed this man to pastor his own church. Amen. And I'm glad that he did. Amen. Good gracious alive. I'm glad that he did. 12 years ago, the Emmanuel Baptist Church of Roebuck did not exist. But God. 10 years ago, this land we worship on tonight was just a patch of woods. But God. Hey, you know, hey, but God decided he wanted a church here. And there's some folks wanted to do all kinds of things here, didn't they? Wanted to buy this land. But God had it on reserve. He had it reserves, huh? Amen. 9 years ago, this beautiful building that we worship in tonight did not exist, but God. But God decided he wanted himself a spot on the side of Stone Station Road that all the world could look at and say, what in the world happened there? Amen. Amen. And by the way, like I say, I didn't get to work with any but one pastor. In fact, he was God. God likes him better than he does most folks. I'm going to tell you that right now. In fact, I'm a little bit upset he likes him better than he does me. Because some of you have been to our place, and we're pleased. God gave us a beautiful metal structure there. But I'm going to tell you what. I have never worked with a pastor in trying to get the church going that God gave him everything he wanted. Literally everything. But God gave him everything that his heart's desired. Didn't he, brother? All he had to, in fact, sometimes he didn't even have to ask for it. He just think about it. God say, all right, I'll take care of that. And none of this would ever have been but God. Brother Frankie, he wanted to put this man in one of the most special places in the state of South Carolina, pastoring one of the most special churches on the planet. But God. And I thank the Lord tonight that God allowed me to have just a part in what God has done here. Now this, and I close. I'm going to ask you tonight. You got a problem? Do you have a problem? Does anybody here tonight have a problem? I mean, you're going tomorrow's Monday, and you know you're going to have to go back out. I'm going to tell you what's the truth. The devil has set out to make every Christian life hard on the job. Amen. And maybe somebody has it. Maybe you have a test this week. Maybe got to go to the doctor. I don't know. Do you have a problem or do you have, I don't know about your spiritual condition. I don't know tonight. Anybody here need revival? Pastor's already said everybody here needs revival, and I know I do. Amen. I know I do. But here's what I'm saying. Whatever your need is tonight, I know the answer. But God. Here it is here. But God. And everything changes. Everything. Everything. Literally. But God commendeth his love toward us. And that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us, and everything changed. And Lord, I thank you tonight for the blessed privilege. It's mine to read this verse of scripture and know it's talking about me. And Lord, I thank you for this privilege to come back here and be with these folks that I love so much and enjoyed being with so much. And I don't think Pastor will mind if I do this tonight. Every head's bowed and every eye's closed still. Anyone here say, preacher, I do have a problem. I do have a problem. On the job, in my family, in my finances, in my heart, I've got a problem. Just slip your hand up, would you? Because God's looking. God's going to see what we're looking. And he knows our heart. Yes, I see those hands all over the building. Well, we have the answer. We have the answer. But God. Pastor, you come on. Yeah. God bless you, brother. I love you. God bless you.
But I guarantee you, there's some folk here tonight that's got problems that didn't raise their hand. We have a God that can. Dr. Harold Seitler preached a message some years ago. Can God? Sort of like, but God. God can, amen. Folk are coming to the altar. Thank you for coming. There may be others that need to come. Some of you folk can come and pray with these folk. If you need to come tonight, slip out and come. He's a good God, folk. You sell out to him, you'll be doing right. Tonight, it's up to you what you're going to do. Thank God for his goodness. Pray for these that are at the altar. If you're here tonight and you're lost without Christ, you got a sin problem. The Lord can take care of that. The Bible says he died for us. You need to come tonight. Slip out and come. When's the last time you talked to him about it? If you got a problem, when's the last time you talked to him about it? When's the last time? You say, well, preacher, he knows everything. He does. You decided to follow him tonight? Decided to turn your life completely, totally over to him? Thank God for the day you commit your life 100% totally to him. Jesus, I have God, thank God. Don't turn him back. We've come too far to look back now. I'm glad I'm saved tonight. I'm glad God intervened in my life and he changed everything. Hallelujah. He changed some of you from drunks. He's changed some of you from drug addicts. He put some of your homes back together. Woo! He gave some of you a good husband and a good wife. Boy, we got so much to thank you for tonight. Boy, we ought to praise him and give him glory and honor. Thank God he let some of us be a part of his work, part of the ministry. Oh, what a thrill that is. Woo! It's amazing just to see God's plan work. Amen. Thank God. I appreciate tonight. Boy, we've had a good service. Thank you, Dr. Ray. Tremendous message. Dr. Ray, I think we need to get together sometime to sit down. Let's just write a book about the experiences that we had during the church. Boy, we had some good ones and bad ones and had some funny ones. Amen. Dr. Ray, you remember when Brother Danny burned our Knox box? Yeah. I remember when Dr. Ray and Brother Dennis would get around on a corner. Yeah. Yeah. Shot his nail gun, shot through his finger up there, working on this up here in this area. Jamie cut him with a sawzall, and of course he was crazy enough to take the wrong end of it, like cut his finger off. Him and Brother Dennis used to stand around and try to sing, and they always want me to let them sing in church, and I never would let that happen. Yeah. You remember when the Hispanic guys were putting a sheetrock up, and it was raining, they needed more sheetrock, and they couldn't get the truck down in here, and those guys say, we carry. And he's going to park up on the road. And them guys going to carry 5/8, 12-foot sheetrock up on the road. So that's where the truck came, and they parked up there. And them jokers didn't walk up there and get it. They ran and got it. And they ran back with it. I'm talking about half a 5/8, 4x12 sheetrock. If you ever picked up a piece of sheetrock, you know what that is. But anyway, we had a long aluminum vault board, remember? Brother Danny took that aluminum walk board there and laid it down in that mud. And me and Dr. Ray had some fun out of it. And the Mexican needed that walk board to put the sheetrock up, and that thing had mud kicked all in it. He went out there and got it and brought it back here and cleaned it up. Brother Danny's the one that took it out there and put it in the mud. So when them Mexicans come up here, we told Brother Danny, he said, hey, those Hispanic guys came up here and wanted to know who put that aluminum walk board out there in that mud. And I said, we told him Brother Danny did. And I said, them Mexicans said, dumb American. Oh, Danny got so mad. He said, oh, tell him who's that boy. Me and old Doc, we laughed at that. I would like to die like he thought. That was so funny. But anyway, we had a great time. We had a wonderful time. In my mind, we could write a book. We really could. On some of the experiences and some of the ways things got. Well, you can have a seat. I told you I'd do this. I'm going to get to sing. He gave me more than I asked for. You'll have to find it, Mac. I'll have to find it. They brought the list up there to me and gave it to me, and the offering was $10,948. So I sent a note down to my wife and said, you make a check for $52. And that made it out to $11,000. While I was sitting in church, didn't have to wait for the mailman to come. Didn't have to wait for the mailman to come. Somebody came from behind me in the rows behind me. Another check for $100. $11,100 in our offering today. And I'm so nervous I can't hardly even find this song. Oh, yeah, the Lord gave us that, raised that money, and sure, that's a $25,000 piano. We bought it for $11,000. Thought we was going to have to use some of our money for our building. We didn't want to do that. We had to have a building more than we needed a piano. But the Lord opened the door, and so that we could get it, we was able to raise the money that morning. In about 15 minutes to go over at Haynes Music at Gaffney and pay cash for that piano. And the only stipulation was we didn't have nowhere to put it. And I said, the only thing about it, y'all going to have to keep it for us until we're ready for it. And they had to do that for us, and they did. You know what? I don't think that song's in here. I don't know. I don't think I could sing it by heart. I could get some of it out. Well, that's where the old devil works. Let me look on this side. Could be on this side. Hey, there it is. Here it is. I got it. Let me see. Let me give me a microphone. Just turn this one off. But I'd holler this amount no matter what. You just have to bear with me, amen. Gave me more than I asked for. Thank the Lord. I say, praise the Lord and thank him for it. Amen. Praise the Lord. He's a good God tonight. Not only because he gave us this $11,100, but because he's good all the time. Amen. If it'd been just $100 offering today, he's still a good God. And I give him glory and I give him praise. All right, Brother Mac. Y'all pray for me. Satan said, this time you've done it, now you've gone too far. How could the Lord receive you now? You are ruined now and scarred. But something deep inside of me said, child, you're still my own. My love for you is still the same. So child, just come back home. He gave me more than I ever asked for, more than I ever dreamed. He gave me more than I could imagine when I came back home to him. When I asked him to forgive me, he gave me a robe and a ring. I said, make me as one of your servants. But he made me a child of the King. Amen. They done it all for us. Amen. Woo, can't get any better than that. Amen. Thought about all the years I've wasted as I walk the homeward way. And I rehearsed time and time all the words that I would say. When I finally climbed that long last hill, my father I did see running with his arms open wide in love to welcome me. And he gave me more than I ever asked for, more than I ever dreamed. He gave me more than I could imagine. Woo! When I asked him to forgive me, he gave me a robe and a ring. I said, make me as one of your servants, but he made me a child of the King. When I asked him to forgive me, he gave me a robe and a ring. When I said, me a servant, but he made me a child of the King. Amen. Well, praise the Lord. That's a blessing. That's sort of a bad way to end up without my singing, but I tell you one thing, boy, that's in my heart tonight, and I thank the Lord for his goodness. I'm looking forward to see what the Lord's going to do for us this week. I really am. You know, if one person would get saved this week, or one child of God get back where they need to be with Jesus this week, it'd be worth all that offering that came in, and it'd be more than that. No way you can put a price on that. Well, I tell you, it'd be a blessing to see people just get right with God. Just get right with God. I appreciate Dr. Ray coming tonight and preaching for us, and his wife, Donna. It's always a joy to have them. Appreciate Brother Ed coming today and being with us, and it's been a special day for us. And not for, when I say us, I'm talking about we as a church. It's been a real blessing. Appreciate one of our missionaries that we support being here tonight, Brother Riley Lindsay. Appreciate Brother Manley and his family coming by tonight and being in our services and praying for their work. Amen. It's a wonderful journey. It's a wonderful journey. And I just praise the Lord for it. Well, we can stay here all night and reminisce and go over some things and talk about some things, but I know some of you got to go to work in the morning. I do. I'm not going to lay in the bed in the morning. In fact, Brother Marvin came by here. I didn't feel good the latter part of the week, Wednesday through Friday. I didn't feel worth shooting, really. Brother Marvin came by here on Thursday to pick the trash up. He'd heard that I wasn't feeling well. Brother Marvin said, I come by here and you wasn't here. He said, preacher, I got worried. I thought something done happened to you. He said, my preacher's always at the church. But I went home early that day to lay down because I didn't feel well. And Brother Marvin called me and checked on me. He said, preacher, are you all right? Well, that's a blessing. I love you, buddy. I love all of y'all. I want you to know that. I don't talk about you and run you down when I go to other churches. You're too good of people to do that. I just praise the Lord for you. I thank God he sent you this way to be a part of this church and to help us in the ministry. I don't intend to do it all, don't want to do it all, can't do it all. But we're in this thing together. This is a we thing. We thing. We're in this thing together. But God's the head. He's the one in charge. He's the one in control. And to him I give all the glory and praise and all the honor for all that he's done. Here you go, Brother Ronnie. Take these, if you would, and take them back out to my apple. Y'all be putting that together in just a minute. But Scott Ding don't like pink. Well, he says he don't. But anyway, you may want to wear your pink shirts. Let's wear them Tuesday night. I fixed him a pink water bottle one year when he came to preach for us. And he always wants a bottle of water. So I got a bottle of water and had it wrapped in hot pink. And when he got ready to preach, I set it up on the pulpit here. He took that thing and threw it on me. But Scott's a blessing. You'll enjoy Brother Scott Dean if you come. And he's got a little humor about him, but he preaches the book and the Bible. And you'll enjoy him. And you'll enjoy, he's got a sweet wife. And y'all come next week, and I know that you'll enjoy Brother Scott Dean. Amen. All right, so let's stand if you would, and we'll be dismissed in a word of prayer. Brother Ed, you want to go ahead and make your way out? And Brother Ray, if you and Sister Donna will go out to the front there, the folk can greet you as we go out. Y'all can go ahead and head back that way. And we're going to be dismissed in a word of prayer. And try to bring somebody with you tomorrow night to the first night of revival. and pray the Lord just give us a great time as we fellowship around the things of God. Brother Raleigh, it's good to have you tonight. I wish Brother Raleigh leaves you, if you would, if you'll dismiss us.